Welcome to this video, which provides a quick glimpse of Azure Cost Management. My name is Terry Clancy. Azure Cost Management, or ACM, is a native Azure service designed to allow customers and partners to gain complete visibility and control of their cloud spend across Azure and Amazon Web Services, or AWS. It is designed to be used by managers, finance users, app teams, and developers, and supports a three-phase process starting with slice and dice tools for visibility, budgeting, RBAC, and scoping tools for accountability, and Azure Advisor cost recommendations for optimization. To access Azure Cost Management, open the Azure portal at portal.azure.com and select Cost Management and Billing, then select Cost Management. And Azure Cost Management generally consists of cost analysis, cost alerts, budgets, advisor recommendations, exports, and cloud connectors. Note that the cloud link you can see there is simply a link to the legacy cloud portal at cloud.com. Let's look at cost management from a visibility perspective. This includes cost analysis and exports. Cost analysis provides several built-in views which can be further customized. The accumulated costs view shows actual or amortized spend for the time period selected for the selected scope. This is optionally shown against any one of potentially many budgets for the selected scope. The selected budget is shown here as a red dashed line. The three pie charts at the bottom show selected spend split by your three most important dimensions and/or tags as selected by you. You can group by any dimension, for example, resource group name. And you can filter on individual members of dimensions by clicking, for example, here or here. Or you can multi-select members of dimensions by clicking on the Add Filter pill here, selecting a dimension. And as you can see, you will have the ability to select multiple dimension members. Once selected, a filter can be removed by clicking here. You can select line charts or column charts, and you can change granularity from the default accumulated to daily or to monthly or to none. None removes time from the x-axis. Controls at the top allow you to save the current view or share it with those that have permissions to see it, or export an image of the report and the data behind it, or to schedule exports of a large table showing costs split with columns for each of the dimensions. All the cost data is also available through a Power BI connector and through APIs. Now let's look at accountability and budgets. To support stakeholder accountability for cloud spend, Azure Cost Management provides very granular capabilities to dissect costs so that each stakeholder can see their respective spends, but not others and not more than they need to. This is supported by role-based access controls, scopes, dimensions, tags, and soon cost allocation and markups, all of which will be discussed in more detail in other videos. Budgets can be set for any scope. If we look at this monthly budget, for example, we can see it's set for $1,500 per month, resetting monthly. If we then edit the budget, we can see that we can further filter that scope. Alerts can be set to be triggered when certain budget thresholds are met. Each alert can be associated with an action group, which gives enormous flexibility in defining actions to be taken when alerts are triggered. Note also that at the bottom here, recipients can be defined to receive emails when any of the budget alerts get triggered. When any of the cost alerts are triggered, they are also listed on the cost alerts page, so you always have a summarized view of all of the alerts. Azure Cost Management provides cost optimization recommendations by enhancing the Azure Advisor Services cost recommendations. If we select advisor recommendations, four categories of recommendations are provided for the selected scope. If we drill into right size or shut down underutilized virtual machines, we see 25 instances of that recommendation. In each case, we can view usage patterns to look at CPU utilization, as well as many other metrics for that VM. If we decide to accept the recommendation, it presents a recommended SKU And there's a selection so we can go ahead and resize it to that recommended size.
Amazon Web Services or AWS spend can be included in Azure Cost Management. The Cloud Connectors Blade allows you to add AWS linked accounts, and you can separate and view Azure and AWS charges when you group by provider, as you can see here in the pop-up box and in the bottom left pie chart. As organizations move to the cloud, cost management is becoming more and more important. Azure Cost Management is designed to satisfy that need and ensure that Azure customers derive optimal value from the cloud. Thanks for listening, and here are some links you may find useful. And please see our other videos in the Azure Cost Management channel on YouTube using the link on this page. All the best with Azure Cost Management.